Alright guys, this is my third video on this series of me talking about some of my favorite characters in video games. In the previous video, my favorite character from Metal Gear Solid 4 was a male character, so you can expect this character to be female. It's pretty obvious, I'm talking about Metal Gear Solid 3. I feel like it's pretty obvious who my favorite character would be if that character was female. It's really, really easy. This is a no-brainer. MGS3 had some great characters, but no other character quite matches her. The boss. Pretty obvious. This is a no-brainer. And really, is she the most important character in the story? Hell yeah, she's the most important. I would argue she's the most important character in the entire franchise. Because of the retcon of, of 4. And the whole franchise as a whole, this Metal Gear Solid saga would not be possible if the boss did not exist. It's because of, the big bosses and Zero's obsession with fulfilling the boss's dream that this whole incident of Outer Heaven and the Patriots and all that came to be because of the boss. So, yes, that's an easy answer. Absolutely, the most important character in the story, in the entire franchise, she's the most important character. So, that's easy. The other reason, she's the most enigmatic female character out there. Like, I still cannot, I struggle when I play, when I play Portable Ops and Peace Walker, I struggle like Big Boss did. Like, what? Why did she do that? It's, even though I play the game, even though multiple times actually, I've watched Cutscene multiple times, the boss has a power of making you question everything about her. And she is, I would argue she's like, in the gaming world, one of the strongest female characters ever. And I told you guys, I love strong female characters, and the boss is pretty damn strong. Enough to beat the living hell out of Big Boss. So really awesome to see that. Just her, she's a master, by the time you come to meet her, she's like the best soldier ever. She has such a unique view of philosophy. Her monologues are just incredible. Her sense of loyalty, her sense of the mission, and the way that she interacts with Snake, this is a no-brainer. Honestly, just the ending of MGS3 is that powerful because of the boss. I really feel like creating the boss as a character was one of Hideo Kojima's most genius ideas ever. And retconning that to have the boss being so integral to the Metal Gear Saga story was such a genius thing to do. And her having ties to her being the mother of Ocelot is also like, whoa, this is a no-brainer, guys. The boss is definitely my favorite character from MGS3. I don't think I really need to explain too much on why that is. How important is the other characters? I guess is a question. If I didn't pick the boss, who would I pick? That's a tougher question, because I feel like MGS3 overall, the character roster, not that strong, because the boss is so strong. But I feel like the cast of the villains in MGS3 was the weakest out of the entire franchise, like personality-wise. The pain, the sorrow, they're all, I think it's intentional because they are the emotions, but that's why they're all one-dimensional. Eva was interesting, but she's the most kind of cliche character there. She's this kind of like sex appeal character. I think it was interesting that at the end, when it turns out that she was a triple agent, that was pretty interesting. Seeing Ocelot develop from this, seeing Ocelot's admiration for Big Boss grow and grow, that was really cool, but Ocelot as a character was kind of just annoying as a whole. So that leaves really the boss and Big Boss, Naked Snake. and I really do like Naked Snake a lot. Think he's an incredible character as well in that story. So it's really up to me. To me, the debate is between Naked Snake and the boss. And Major Zero. Zero is a really interesting character. The support cast is not as strong, I think, and as compared to a lot of the other Metal Gear Solid games. But you know, they're pretty cool. They serve as well. Sigint was. He's funny, but how stereotypical can you get? Because, you know, come on. And Paramedic was, you know, I don't know. I don't know what to think about Paramedic. I'm kind of neutral on Paramedic. But, yeah, this is a no-brainer. The boss, one of the most awesome female characters in gaming, in my opinion. And definitely really unique. It's really hard to think of a human female character that's like that, like physically strong, mentally strong, emotionally strong. This is a really strong character with a lot of mystery and enigma behind her. You can't really quite figure the boss out. In fact, the Zero and Big Boss trying to figure the boss out, that's what ended up pretty much almost destroying the entire world, figuring out that mystery. So that's a pretty powerful character, if you ask me. That's my thoughts on characters from MGS3. Leave a comment if you want. You know, tell me what you think. What did you think of the boss or any of the characters in MGS3? And so, since this was a female character, the next video is going to be about a male character. I know it might seem like a hard thing to do, but trust me, I pretty much planned out which game and which characters I'm going to talk about. This series is going to have about 30 videos, and from the looks of it, it's going to be pretty good, female and male-wise. So, yeah, look forward to that.